Today I want to talk to you about the important crop stage of cutout. Cutout essentially is the point in the crop's life where vegetative expansion and the production of new fruiting sites comes to an end, and the crop from that point onwards focuses on filling the bowls that it's retained up until that point through until defoliation. So when it comes to assessing whether your crop has reached the cutout stage, a lot of people sample consecutive plants counting the number of nodes above white flower. And for most people, they use a measure of 4 to 4.5 nodes above white flower to determine if indeed their crop has reached cutout. So if we look at this particular plant here, it's Cycott 74 BRF variety. You can see we've got today's white flower here, and above that white flower, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes. This plant here is very much cut out and will focus on filling the bowls that is retained up until this point. One of the interesting things that is often overlooked at cutout is that whilst the number of bowls that a plant is going to retain and take through to the end of the season is pretty much fixed at this point in time, in that you're not growing additional fruiting sites, the actual size of those bowls and the level at which they've filled out at this stage in the crop's life is only about 30 to 40% of what you're actually going to pick by the end of the season. So between this point now and defoliation, the crop is still yet to accumulate about 60 to 70% of the dry matter that will go into those bowls and the lint and the seed that you pick at the end of the season. So whilst the crop has finished expanding vegetatively, it still has a lot of work to do and is very dependent on your management of water and insects, keeping in mind that the number of bowls that you have from this point onwards is finite, but the size of those bowls and how well they finish is very much dependent on effective management of those parameters that we can control between now and when the bowls are physiologically mature.